Hey everyone, Logrosif here, and once again, as you can see, we are in XCOM Enemy Within with the Peter and Pawn Squad. Right then, so a couple of things to sort out. Firstly, I'm going to try and make these episodes a little bit longer and edit a little bit less to try and make them a bit more coherent when it comes to like the actual combat and things like that. I'm still going to cut out like all the animations and transitions and things where I'm just basically sort of figuring stuff out, you know, the pointless stuff which no one needs to see. But when it comes to the actual gameplay, I'll try and leave most of that in so it's hopefully a bit more coherent. That is going to make the episodes a little bit longer, but hopefully you guys are okay with that and that will make the episode maybe a little bit more enjoyable. So that's the main thing really. Other than that, let's get right on into it. So let's go to the situation room, because I've literally just loaded this up. It's been a couple of days, so I need to refresh myself what we're doing as well. So we're gonna lose Russia because the council report's due in a couple of days, so yeah, we're definitely gonna lose Russia with that amount of panic, and we haven't got our satellite over there, which we really should, but we missed, unfortunately. So we're going to lose Russia, but we've got everyone else. Canada is going to be a prime target for the next satellite, so that's going to be a thing. We've got a satellite over the UK. We now have money because we did that, so we've got 217 credits, which is quite a lot of money considering. So we should get a... Negative. That equipment should be passed on. We should get a Raven over Europe, so we need to order one. We'll get one. That's 3 days. So that's basically what we got. 3 days is the council report anyway. 2 days for the satellite to be operational over Egypt. So we need to sort that. And that's about it. Experimental warfare, that's 7 days. So that's plenty. So that's that. That's the hangar. We got to go to the barracks. What were we doing here? We had some people wounded. Jess, Claire, and Molly are all wounded. So I've got a couple of days. Lucy O'Brien, she's in April O'Neill. There you go. We've got April O'Neill, we've got John and Jane Shepherd, Meredith, Sam, and Chloe. Okay, and Atomic Pistol there, of course. Okay, fantastic. So I actually had a reminder, or I wrote this down for myself. Lucy O'Brien, she's a random. So let's customize her name, because this is another Pizza and Porn person, another excellent Pizza and Porn person. One of the best episodes there was. And is it Ashmore? I think it's Ashmore. There we go. If that's spelled wrong, I'll spell it correctly the next episode. But yeah, Dana. I'm going to say Dana. That's got to be the way it's pronounced. Dana Ashmore. She was an excellent guest on one of the Pizza and Bones, and that was one of the best episodes there's been. That doesn't look like anything like it, but at some point I will redo the visuals there, so that actually looks like it. Okay, so what we're doing engineering-wise. We've got some engineers, we've not got anyone being augmented. We've still got money. Build facilities. We need another satellite uplink for the... where is the satellite uplink? I need this for the satellite. So let's build one of those. That's going to give us the ability to launch another 3 satellites. So if we can, let's buy another 3 satellites. So where's our satellites? There they are. 62 manufacturer. How many can we buy? We can buy one. Well, one might be enough right now for Canada. So let's do that. Uplink target name, not interested in that. Gas grenade, nanofiber vest, scope. And it might be worth getting the scope maybe, but the money. We're getting a bit low on money again, even though we're about to get some. What else, can we build anything? Oh, we're out money. Now we're out money, okay. So that's that done. And research-wise, what are we working on? We're working on experimental warfare. Like I said, we need to do these things, but they're taking a while. We need to get some more scientists. That's something we need to do, more scientists. Carapace armor, that's a must. We need that, but we need more scientists. And the Arc Thrower, that's the next thing. Right, okay then. So I think that's us all done. Let's go to Mission Control and find our next mission. If we actually even have a next mission, it might be just the council report. Let's see what we get. Okay, here we go.
Unfortunately, one of our members has chosen to discontinue their involvement in the XCOM project.
Yeah, so Russia's withdrawn. That's because, of course, the aliens... Well, the panic's rose into a certain extent. Anyway, so we're doing pretty much all right. France and Australia are a worry. We're going to have to keep an eye on those, and especially Canada as well. So that's stuff to sort out.
Remember, we...
Yep, I know you're like the overbearing parent. You're always watching. Okay, so... Scan for activity, let's see what we've got next. I know we've got some people back on active duty, so Jessica's back and Claire's back. We've got our interceptor. Assign new research. Yes, let's do that. We've got flashbang grenade, phoenix cannon. We need to do that. Reaper rounds, foundry. Okay, all those things are good. All those things are great. Yes, yes, yes. All these things. All right. Can we restore? Can we? So it's going to take 12 days, but I still think we should go after it. But no, let's do the arc throw. We need to do the arc throw. Right, is everyone back? Only Molly's left, and she's got 3 days. Okay, great stuff. But everyone else is back. We have got some absolute badasses all ready to rock. We're all done with the medals. Okay, cool. I don't think we need any more soldiers. Excellent stuff. So we're just waiting on that then. And we got our hangar. That's there. Excellent stuff. All right, and we've got a hell of a lot of money there. Holy crap. Okay, we've got some stuff to do. We can augment our soldiers. Now, we can't do... Can we... Whoa, hang on a second. So I thought if we had the G-modded soldier and we mechanized them, that they would lose their G-mods. And that appears to be the case. Now, I feel like I should do it to the shepherds because, you know, they, like, actually are cyborgs in one way or another. So, let's do that. Let's do John Shepherd. Let's augment soldier. There we go. We need to build the... That's a priority. We need another power generator. So, let's buy another power generator. So, we're getting another power generator. And we need to do... Ah, we need 2 power. We haven't got that yet. 5 days. Okay. So we're building another power generator. As soon as we do that, we can build another access lift, clear out this level, and start filling in this level as well. Okay, good stuff. Good stuff. Other than that, we can't do anything until we get some more power. So we're kind of stuck with that for now. Right, and we had to build some stuff as well, didn't we? Let's build by items. Here we go. So we're gonna want a Phoenix cannon. We're gonna want 3 of those for our 3 interceptors. Uplink, we don't want that, not really too fussed about that. We need to buy another 2 of these, and then we can launch all the satellites. Any more abilities? I would like Chloe to have adaptive bone marrow, so let's do that. So we've got that. Let's go to the hangar, view ship list, and we want to upgrade. Selecting a specific jet within the hangar, you can choose to modify. We'll upgrade our Ravens to the Phoenix cannon. Which is pretty good. They've got short range, but they're more powerful than the standard missiles. So we'll do that. We need to edit loadout. Phoenix cannon. Confirm. Back again. And Europe. That's the other one. Edit loadout. Phoenix cannon. That's the last one. Takes 24 hours. Okay. No worries. Right, so we're still waiting for a little bit, but not too long. Let's go to mission control and see what's next. Right, all the Ravens are back on with the Phoenix cannon, and we have our alien abductions. So let's see what we've got. Okay, so we've got France with high difficulty and 4 engineers. We actually could do with more scientists than engineers right now, but fair enough. Mexico's easy, and we get a new lieutenant, which, you know, that's not bad. But we kind of need to go for the countries that got high panic, and we get 200 credits, dollars, pounds, non-descendable currency, freedom dollars. Yeah, let's do Paris, France, because that's the difficult one. Let's go for it. Right, how are we doing for guys? Let's see. Is Chloe not available? Is she still in gene lab? She is. She's got 1 hour. 1 hour to go, and then she's out. And same thing with John Shepherd as well. 1 hour, and then he's out. Okay. Well, we'll take this. Isn't necessarily a super important mission. It's mildly difficult, but we could certainly take more rookies and get them leveled up. Although, we'll be honest, we've got a corporal and 2 corporals and a rest of lieutenants. So yeah, let's get these guys leveled up. We've got 2 medikits. Yeah. Okay. I think we're good to go. So you might notice that the armor's looking a bit different. Basically, I got the DLC pack for the armor, making it look about 10 times better. Yeah, scientifically 10 times better. All right, let's launch mission, and we'll see what we've got to deal with in France. Okay, so it's your bog standard abduction mission. They say it's going to be difficult. Basically, that means that there's going to be certain types of aliens here, I should imagine, and about 10 of them, I should think. As always, we've got Mel to find as well.
Strike one is cleared to engage.
And we're in the corner, so we've got... This is going to be a little bit easier to discern. We've just got to go over this way. Right then, so... Where should we go? Shall we take cover behind here?
I'm rolling.
Let's move Claire Max. Where shall we move Claire Max?
On the move.
Right, Jess, we got a decent place to move Jess. I kind of want her in cover wherever we're going to put her. I'm assuming they're going to be in here rather than up here, so let's put her in cover.
Visual on the goods.
Okay, so there's our meld, so that's where we want to be moving to. Let's move Sam. Oh, there's Sam. Oh, yeah. Let's move Molly here.
What we've seen so far,
there we go, we got some mutons. So the mutons are pretty tough. The mutons are pretty goddamn tough.
I don't envy anyone who is to go up against that thing.
Right, luckily we're all under cover here, so this shouldn't be too bad. Nice shot, Claire. 3 health.
I'm all right.
That'll be because Claire's got the reaction on someone else firing on her rather than just moving, so that's not a bad skill to have. And there we go, we got a mute on there on Overwatch. Lovely. Excellent. Brilliant. I'm just gonna go for it. Just gonna see what we got.
It would be preferable if we attempted to retrieve those canisters rather than destroying them.
Probably not the best tactic, but I kind of want to get this guy without triggering his Overwatch.
Shot failed to connect.
I feel like we need to move away from this car because that's going to explode at some point.
Understood. Moving out.
Again, Claire, excellent with the shot. Three health. Not bad at all. Not bad at all. I'm just gonna put Sam on Overwatch.
I'm alright.
Nice one, Sam. Come on, Sam. We can do it. Three health. Excellent. This is why we need to upgrade to beam weapons, especially with the mutons. The mutons are tricky. Well, they can be. Who are you going to go after? You're going after Claire. And you're shooting through the wall. You're shooting through the wall. Alright, let's go ahead, shot. It's probably not going to kill him, even if he does hit. Go for it, Claire, see what you can do. Not quite.
Shot wide. That's affirmative.
Right. So Molly's the heavy, she should be able to take this guy out. No problem. You're right there.
Negative damage.
That's the problem, man. The heavy weapons are hard to aim.
That's affirmative.
I got partial cover there, so at least we got something. I'm counting on Meredith to get rid of this one, or at least take him down to health, and then Jessica to get rid of this one up here, because he's got less health. Although, actually, they've both got the same health now, but she's losing her cover slowly but surely. So, why not? We're still in cover there, we're still in cover. Let's go after this one. Nice one, Jess. Excellent. That's the muton down. So multiple shots from multiple people to take these guys down, whereas like the sectoid's not, you know, one shot from a decent troop and take him down, no problem. We've also lost a meld, which is not great.
Orders confirmed. On
enemy
the move.
Troops.
Oh, brilliant! We got the seekers again, and they've gone stealth. Wow. This is something we'll have to keep in mind. Right, at least we've got someone on Overwatch. We've got these seekers over here, but you know what? As long as all these guys are reasonably close together, they should be able to cover each other when the seekers come. Alright, I think we're going to move Jess up here, put a vine full cover there. Hopefully that'll be good enough. Oh great, so we've got some thin men as well. They kind of come out of nowhere, and Meredith has taken one out immediately. Fantastic, excellent stuff. And we've got two flows. The body count here is really going to rack up. This is really racking up. We've got one of our guys out. Alright, let's get rid of this seeker. Meredith can take out this guy. Although we probably should move behind some better cover because
Roger that.
I want to be able to take this guy out and stay protected from those guys. So let's do that. Got a pretty good chance of hit. There we go.
Empty. Can't
engage. Now, right, where can you go? Where can you go, Sam? Need to get you in cover in one way or another.
Already there.
So let's put you there. There we go.
On the move.
I think we should put Jess over here.
Heading to that location.
At least you're in cover. Let's see if you take out one of the floaters for us.
Need a resupply.
That's good enough. That's good enough. As we're whittling you down. Okay, so the seekers can fire. I did not know that. I felt like I should have known that already, and yeah, that's kind of a surprise. Oh, right. Okay, Molly. Please. Please, Molly, take out this guy. Excellent stuff. Oh, Meredith, we're gonna have to move you over here, and then we need you to reload as well.
Roger that.
And we've got an Overwatch, and they miss. Excellent. Wow, this has got tense all of a sudden.
Ready to rock.
Right, I really want Sam to take out this dude. Excellent, Sam's got this guy, right. Please, Sam, take out this seeker.
Negative damage.
God damn it. Okay, what you got for me, Max? Right, you need to reload.
Ready
okay,
to rock.
Let's reload you. Jessica's pretty safe there, but I would like her to be in some sort of proper cover. It's kind of tricky because we've only got so much cover to work with inside this shop, and it's not great cover to be honest with you. Bit of a surprise this one. I was not expecting to see aliens up here either. Alright, this one's gone stealth, but we've got this one over here. At least we're in a better spot to pick up this guy over here, we'll be honest. See, he's got a better chance of hitting this guy, so I'm going to send Sam after the floater, and I'm going to trust that the other guys can sort out the seeker that's got Molly. So, let's do that. Come on, guys. Do me proud, do yourselves proud.
They're repositioning on us. They're on the
mic.
You need to reload.
Good to go.
I kind of feel like I should have moved you and then reloaded, but okay. Excellent. Oh, Meredith, you're a hero. Absolutely a hero. Absolute hero. Fantastic. Right. Okay, now we're in a bit of a better spot. Let's send Meredith back here. And Jess, you know what? I am just going to put you on Overwatch for now until we're sure that we're clear around here. There's probably going to be a mute on left. But before we do anything, We need to reload. Reload everything.
Affirmative. Moving out.
And we need to make sure everything's clear so that we're not going to run into a trap. Jess, you better reload.
Let's rock.
Molly, you can go up here and
rolling out.
Watch out for Claire. We'll watch Claire's back. And Meredith will send you there. And you can watch their back. Everyone watch everyone else's back. And that was supposed to be an overwatch, not a reload.
What was that?
Right, so the alien's just around the corner. Oh, here he is. Oh man, this is getting intense. This is getting intense. He's right there. He's right outside the door. We've also lost both the melds. A minor concern right now. Okay guys. Come on. He's got 2 health. We can take him out. We can take this guy. It's no problem. It's no problem. Oh, you got another shot. Go for it, Meredith. Okay. Well, you know, you can't win them all. You can't win them all. I'm going to run a gun.
Going in for the kill.
We're going to take a bit of a risk here.
On the move.
And we're just going to go for it. Right in the face. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. This game and its RNGs. It does annoy me so much that this game will just roll the dice on anything. It's like, you're right there. You should be able to hit him. These are trained soldiers. They should be able to hit him. Come on. Should be able to hit him. He's right there. See, that makes sense. That makes sense to me. Okay. We'll put our, Molly on Overwatch. Of course, we've still got the other guy on stealth. I forgot about this. Oh man. Yeah, you know, I gotta be honest with you. Haven't done the best job this mission.
Aye,
to be honest with you, I've been forgetting things.
Damn it. Moving to position.
And we're just gonna go around everyone, put them in cover, and then see if they can take them out.
X-ray neutralized.
There we go. Fantastic. So we must still have someone around, either a seeker or someone else. But let's put them on Overwatch. And Jess, I am going to get you in some cover because that is really wigging me out right now. You not being in cover. I'm so just programmed with XCOM. It's like if people aren't in cover, then I'm just not a happy bunny. That is how I play this game. Overwatch and cover. That's it. And we're really just holed up in the store. This is the best. Right, we've got either a guy. This is what we're looking for. It's a thin man. I've really been forgetting where they've all gone. We've really got distracted by being flanked and all that. And people are not in the best of health. All right, we need to find a way to get up there with cover in mind. I'm going to send Jess there. I think Sam's in cover there. Oh, Jess has got a shot. Excellent. Let's just see if we can hit him.
That is not good. Okay.
I don't understand how you can see him from there, but okay. Okay, we've almost got him. Just one more shot. Oh, Molly, if you can make this shot, you will be my very own hero of the game. My very own MVP. And he's on the run. I've got him on the run. And he misses. Okay, let's go for a headshot. Why not? Last shot of the game. Oh, Sam. MVP.
Another one down.
Oh, thank God. There we go. So we lost our meld, but we didn't lose any operatives. You know, that's a win in my book. That's a win in my book. All right. Paris, France is safe once again. Excellent. And that was another mission done and dusted. Wow. Yeah, that's actually a pretty tense one. The ones previously have not been half as tense as that. It's those mutons. Those mutons instantly. The mutons, man, they are tough customers. But I'm glad we took them out. We really need to get on with the lasers and the better armor and things like that. Right, so Sam is now a captain, and we have opportunists to eliminate the aim penalty on reaction shots, and we have executioner. Confers plus 10 aim. Right, I think we went for opportunists last time, so I'm going to go for that again, because that's really cool. And Molly McIsaac, nuke. We're going to have to change that. And then what to give, what nickname to give Molly McIsaac? We'll have to figure that out. I will figure that out for the next episode. Right, shredder rocket and suppression. Fire barrage. You know, I think Meredith has suppression, so I think we should have shredder rocket. Let's do that. That sounds pretty damn cool. All right. What else we got? We've got some stuff. We've got some people. We've got people. We've got some mutant autopsy. We've got some corpses. Weapon fragments. Okay, all good stuff. Panic is in France has decreased by 2. Excellent. Panicking is increased in Asia and increased in North America. 4 engineers. We got some 4 engineers. Excellent stuff. How's panic looking? Russia's out. Japan's up a bit. Australia's up a bit. It's a good thing we've got these satellites coming. Canada. Right, we won't lose Canada though. We've got our satellite on the way in 13 days, and the uplink in 7 days. That is not bad at all. That is not bad. Okay guys, so that's it for this episode of XCOM, and yeah, I'll see you again next time. Be sure to subscribe as always for more of this and more videos of other games when I eventually get round to making them. I gotta say, the review of Alien Isolation is taking a little bit longer because that's a very long game, but I do want to play it through to the end because I'm aware that extra things happen at the end and towards the end of the game, and I want to get like a proper picture of the whole entire game. So that's coming. It's just taking a bit of time, which is why we have this to sort of fill the void. So as always guys, thanks very much for watching, and please leave me a like, dislike, comment, however you want to communicate with me. That would be fantastic. And yeah, I'll see you again next time.